seriously powerful headliners.
Powerful, yes. But how powerful, we will see.
Big personalities, too.
With everything going on right now, we simply cannot afford to lose contact with the Sanctum or Wanda.
None of that matters unless they can help us get to Wanda.
Well met. Are you ready? The prophecy of the Midnight Sun does not linger, and neither should we. Lilith possesses the Darkhold. If she forced her way into my Sanctum Sanctorum once, I suspect she can do it again.
You are a Sorcerer Supreme. Can you not predict her movements?
Normally, yes. But since your mother breached the Sanctum, my sense of the future has grown volutinous in nature.
Is that another language, or...?
Fuzzy. My predictions are fuzzy. For the first time as Sorcerer Supreme, I cannot foresee how the future unfolds, and with my apprentice in danger, we cannot tarry.
I understand the urgency. Your apprentice is in grave danger, yes?
Wanda is no mere apprentice. She is the Scarlet Witch, one of the strongest magical practitioners I have encountered. But she hasn't channeled such power on her own since... Never mind. One crisis at a time. I do not doubt Wanda's capability, but without my predictive acumen, I cannot bolster the wards should she need it. Still, the wards are woven into the Sanctum's very essence. They should hold. In any case, all will be revealed with time. I suggest we make use of it while it still functions. We should hurry. As much as I'd love to hear a first-hand account of your exploits, time is of the essence, I'm afraid. Wanda can maintain the wards, I'm certain of that. But perhaps we shouldn't linger?
About time.
Not just about time, Mr. Brooks. Time, space, reality, the building blocks of magic. All must be constant for my portals to work properly. Yet as we now know, that is no longer the case.
We've heard.
Several times.
Otherwise, I would still be hunting dread maidens in my sleep.
Indeed. And while I certainly appreciate the view of this vista, I fail to see how it will hasten our return to the Sanctum.
Magic is the answer.
No, as I've just stated, magic is the problem.
Your magic is. Not ours. The ground you are standing on exists within two worlds. A mystical anchor point to Illyana's realm that allows her to... Well, I'll just let her show you.
Any more questions?
standing in limbo. Nexus of all realities, both real or otherwise. A chaotic but secret realm, beyond the influence of Lilith. Thus far.
Are you certain of that? Because I am sensing all kinds of...
dark energy. That feeling you're being watched. General Hellho vibe.
Yes. All these potentialities converging at once? Truly surprising feat, Miss Rasputin. For someone so young, of course.
You think this is crazy? Wait until you see Manhattan.
From here, magic can open gateways to just about anywhere on our planet, and beyond. We don't want to risk punching through the wards protecting your sanctum, Doctor, so we've chosen a safe exit a few blocks over instead.
Couldn't be worse than the last time.
It was just a simple miscommunication.
Ocean Avenue. I said Ocean Avenue, Magic.
At least we know the wards of protection are still in place.
For now.
I suggest we hurry.
Arm Alpha in position!
Welcome to New York.
I hesitate to call this good news, but I'm seeing minimal Hydra resistance between you and the Sanctum.
Looks can be deceiving, I'm afraid. There's no way these foot soldiers are behind the disruption of the wards of protection.
With that mouth? Your fate is sealed. Lilith herself could not best me. What makes you think you will fare any better?
Show you the way. search for wealth and power with just a tinge of fascism. Hydra will never change. Something.
As ordered. Slow me down.
This is gonna get messy.
That gamma spike we detected in your area seems to be growing. Let's assume that's not a good thing.
Gamma or not, I feel the hand of my mother at work here.
Prepare!
The light shines on the most dutiful.
No mercy for the servants of Willem.
Hail that!
This is going to be...
I've summoned creatures of the void larger than you. Wanda is calling out to me. I feel her struggle. Need to concentrate and... And I won't be doing that again.
Cannot possibly match your strength.
Misguided as they are, remember, Hydra is still human, Hunter. Not Lillen.
You were saying?
The lifeblood of the mother pumps through our veins. The mother is eternal. Hydra is eternal.
Wanna bet?
Wanda!
Wards, weakening! Cannot let them...
is not going to like this.
Nope.
I'll handle it.
Oh,
not?
We do not fear your magic, little wizard. We have answered the Mother's call. We are venom to all who oppose her. And you are lies.
Escalated quickly. Do I even want to know what that beast is?
It calls itself Venom. Until now, a pale imitation of a very heroic young friend of mine.
We will feed your ugly tongue to the spider wizard. Marinate it in his stomach juices and eat it with his spleen.
Welcome, assistants.
This battle requires.
We will peel back your flesh!
Oh, disgusting.
No fair getting back! Belongs to Mother now. As you belong to us, we shall start with your juicy entrails. Then, slowly savor your delicious brains.
Are the rest of your mother's children so chatty?
Thankfully, no.
Can't escape her wrath.
I'm impressed. Still in my prime. This won't end.
We may not be ready for this thing yet. Might be smarter to pull back until we know what we're up against here.
Yes. Surrender. Be eaten. Fill my belly with your tasty fear.
Fill your belly with my plague, demon. Shall be of great help. Too weak for this fight.
No scampering away!
I am caught up here!
Better not stain my cloak.
Mother blesses us with power. Mother! Blesses us with strength! We protect you. loaded with your meat.
And to think Lilith was a vegetarian.
How angry you've made my cloak.
You should not have come here, Lilander. Your friends cannot help you. Mother may have claim on your soul, but your brains shall be ours.
No escape from me, demon.
Hold up. We don't know what we're dealing with yet.
Friendly. Seemed like you folks could use a hand, Doc.
Spider-Man!
Jeez, Eddie, what happened to you? That's part of a horrifyingly terrible new look. The tongue was gross enough, but...
Whoa!
Someone is extra touchy today.
We will rip your face off and suck the pearl from your bones!
Always nice to see you too, buddy.
So, I'm thinking your friends here could use a little break. How about I take Eddie here for his afternoon walk? Don't worry, Doc. That's just his way of saying he cares!
Congratulations.
New world or not, some things remain unchanged.
The look.
What look?
Boldly charging headfirst into the jaws of your enemy. Courageously risking the lives of yourself and your teammates. Just to play the hero. This is the Fire Dragon all over again.
Fire Dragoon. My memories may be fragmented, but as I recall, I killed the bastard.
And all it cost was a village.
Ah, of course. I see it now. The look.
Cut him some slack. It wasn't that simple.
It never is. Which is why I sent you to help. If Spider-Man hadn't come along today, we could have lost far more than...
Than the Sanctum?
Or Wanda.
She means I could have died. Again, putting an end to her eternal crusade against my mother.
You've been through a lot. For now, it's enough that you all made it back in one piece. More or less. We'll talk more later. Get some rest. Not to be the nagging old lady, but I told you not to push too hard.
That was a complete fiasco.
And it would have been far
worse. Hey, for what it's worth, I think you did okay out there. You got some decent hang time, even given you were wearing, what, 70, 80 pounds of chainmail? On the Stark scale of reckless yet daring heroics, I give it a solid 6 out of 10. Don't worry, you'll get there. With a little help.
Your support is appreciated.
Oh, no problem. Already got a few ideas cooking. You're not allergic to memetic poly... You know what? Never mind. Why spoil the surprise? I couldn't help but overhear Auntie Caretaker over there telling you to get some rest. It sounds like a good idea to me. I suppose I could keep you company on the way, seeing as our rooms are in the same direction and all. Besides, no one should be forced to walk the hallways around here alone. So, here we are. The old room, huh? It's not bad. Functional. Solid construction. Almost cozy. Love the antique furnishings from the early Mephisto collection. Full transparency, Hunter, there's another reason I asked to join you here, other than my abject terror of this entire facility. Stopped here before, while you were out. Wanted to surprise you with a nice little housewarming present. Was all set to write you a lovely welcome note, but I'm fairly certain that wasn't red ink in your quill.
Thanks for the gift, Tony.
I think you'll like it. It's a limited edition.
A limited edition what?
Oh, you'll see. Well, I suppose I should leave before whatever monstrosity that is most definitely hiding under your bed jumps out, rips my face off, and then proceeds to feast on my soul. I'll leave you to it.
May your sleep be filled with pleasant dreams, Tony.
Right back at you. Oh, and if you hear the shrieking of a grown man, please ignore it. It's just me walking to my room.
I'm Tony Stark, but if you're hearing this message, you already know that. When I'm not saving the world, I solve the world's problems with technological means, like the one you're holding. I call it the Spark, a secure information and communication device built only for superheroes. It does all the usual, private messages, pictures, and calls for some reason. But it also comes with access to Superlink, a private social network exclusively for your cape-wearing, world-saving compatriots. You might ask, Tony, aren't you just repurposing a failed product from your communications division? If you do, I'll revoke access and let everyone else know you're a jerk. I call it the Wonder Man rule.
My old journal. Maybe it is time I start writing in it again. There was never enough room for my armor in this thing. We were all so happy then.
Child. Charlie! I know, I missed you too.
Let her enjoy the moment. She's been visiting your door every morning for the past 300 years.
Oh, it must have been so hard on her.
Not just her. I suppose that's why I might have been a little curt before.
A little?
You already made the ultimate sacrifice once. Maybe I'm in no rush to see you do it again.
We do not choose our destiny.
But we can choose to duck.
First lesson you ever taught me.
And still the most important. Especially now that you have all these eyes on you.
I have noticed.
To these people, you are a being of myth and legend. A grand hero of old. And they're right. You are a hero. But I also know the battle that rages within your soul. It's not enough that you are a hero. You need to decide what type of hero you will be. I'm sure there will be plenty of opportunity for that in the days to come. For now, I would head to the forge. Our new guests are eager to show you something. This was a lot easier when it was just you and I beheading the Dark Legion as we traipsed through the woods.
Don't forget about Agatha.
I never could. Charlie was restless all night. I should have known something was wrong. We'll talk more later, but for now, Stark has requested your presence in the forge. I think he has another present for you.
Next thing I know, the Sanctum is airborne and covered in slime.
I don't get it. Strange couldn't just magic his way in?
Something about the whole alien thing threw off his mojo.
That explains so much. No wonder he gets so strange around me. See what I did there?
I'm a vampire. I see everything.
This is gonna be a fun apocalypse.
Oh, check out Blade making nice with a...
Now?
Think you can tell your friend inside there to turn it up a few hundred Kelvin?
I could. However, it might shatter the containment spell preventing him from incinerating this facility.
I think we're good. And just in time.
The Forge has certainly changed.
Right. Caretaker said this all happened after your siesta. What spooky castle would be complete without its own Babylonian demon-powered furnace?
Sumerian Fire Demon. His name is Babs.
Oh, now it all makes sense. Well, once you get past the esoteric terror of the situation, I've found this thing actually has some uses. Molecular bonding, breaking down evil gamma serums, fashion accessorizing.
Yes, speaking of...
Oh, right. It's ready.
Your armor seemed to offer minimal protection against the venom creature.
I noticed.
Yeah, I thought you could use an upgrade.
Well hammered, well fired. Caretaker did not mention that you two were such skilled smithies.
Yep, I am Iron Smithy.
Perhaps you should just try it on.
Think it could have used a cloak.
Stylish, damn near indestructible, and we even got the size right. Not bad for our first collaboration.
I still think it could have benefited from a cloak.
You think everything could benefit from a cloak? I hate to admit it, but somehow this ancient forge puts any arc reactor I've got to shame. Who would have thought mystically bound demon power would be so damn energy efficient? Or carbon neutral? Certainly got that new suit of yours done a lot faster than I expected. Speaking of, what's the verdict, boss?
It is
nice having an armorer on demand.
Anytime. I tried to make this version a little less palatable to that symbiote thing. I was this close to making it menthol flavored. But tools are just one part of the equation. You gotta know how to use them too. You were out, what, 300 years before we woke you from your eternal rest? I'm betting you have questions, so ask away, Hunter.
I take it this new version is a technological marvel?
Impact-resistant carbon composites, some patent-pending alloy mesh, and a few touches from Dr. Spooky over there. And hey, the built-in communicator means we can talk to each other without sending a raven.
So it is a marvel, then?
Lightweight, nearly indestructible, and modular enough for future upgrades. Frankly, I wouldn't have used your old suit to wax the Mandarin's car.
Is all this magic a threat to your new technology?
It might surprise some people to hear this, but I do like some things with rules. Isotope decay, magnetic fields, and gamma oscillation make a lot more sense to me than Eye of Newt, bat wings, and a sprinkle of sunshine. At least they did before everything changed.
But you and the doctor seem to work well together.
Well, no need to put a label on things. The guy is good at making sense of this madness every now and then. When he's not talking to his cape.
Seen anything strange around here?
What, other than my roommate? Boom! Roasted! But on a more serious note, this place is legitimately haunted. Mirrors look back at you. My room rearranges itself. And worst of all, magic cats.
I'm sure there are worse places to be.
Oh, true. I could be rooming next to Carol. Her snoring is loud enough to wake the dead. Really, really tired people. Don't get me wrong, I'm happy we have a place free from Lilith's influence. While it lasts.
What sort of things are you doing in here?
Oh, that's right. You were out a while. Basically, we've got a gigantic demon inside the magic box here that provides near limitless power for whatever we might need. Sounds insane, but sometimes it's easier to just go with it.
Okay. So, why not magically create a way through that symbiote shield?
Have you ever known it to work that way? We can't just wish upon a star here. We need to know what we're making first and put together the right components. Otherwise, I'd have already whipped up Strange a new personality.
You must have an interesting origin story of your own.
Well, just your typical American boy. Pops was a founding member of the military-industrial complex. Mom, a famous socialite. Tragedy struck when I lost them both in a car crash, which turned out to be a hit from a rival corporation. I spent my early teens at MIT, trying to clear my head, and was all set to follow in Dad's footsteps as a war profiteer. Then one day, fortune shined on me, in the form of some errant shrapnel that lodged itself just above my heart. So I did what anybody in that situation would do. I built a supersuit and started fighting crime.
I guess we have all had difficult childhoods here.
Yeah, no kidding. I can't tell you how hard it was to memorize all that at Skrull Sleeper Camp. Just kidding. Or am I?
Thanks for catching me up on things.
Anytime. Oh, and speaking of things, remember that creepy gamma goop you found from that hopped-up Hydra soldier? Well, I gave it a peek, and it explains a lot. If you have a minute, meet me at the anvil over there, and I'll walk you through it. I promise it'll be worth your time.
Ah, Hunter. Word?
Hunter, your new attire suits you quite well. But how are you holding up on the inside? I know it's easy to look upon me and simply see the universe's utmost authority on all things mystical and macabre, Hunter. However, in addition to being Earth's Sorcerer Supreme, I am also your doctor.
You mean a physician of the medical arts? You jest.
I assure you, Hunter, I do not jest. They don't call me Mr. Strange, now do they? Except for Tony. Your awakening ritual was admittedly a touch more chaotic than I had originally intended, and, well, after your violent encounter with Venom, my oath to Hippocrates compels me to check in with you. Simply put, how do you feel?
Physically, I am fine. However, I do feel some...
grogginess, a tinge of nausea, sense of memory loss upon time of passing, watery or itchy eyes, common side effects when one is pulled back into the light. Believe me, I know. If any other symptoms arise, you can always tell me. Particularly if you develop a craving for brains. I have a cream for that. In any event, I, for one, do not know if I will ever feel 100% again after the events of yesterday. I still can't believe what transpired, the sanctum, all that knowledge, Wanda, lost, swallowed whole by the black mouth of that foul venom creature. With all my resources, all my gifts, I should have seen this outcome spelled out in the sacred geometry of this universe years ago. But I miscalculated.
I would rather stand down a horde of rampaging Lillin than face one of Agatha's mathematics puzzles. Sacred or not, geometry be damned.
I'd be lying if I said it wasn't my least favorite requirement in pre-med. Still, if only I had studied harder, I would have reached some deeper understanding that could have altered this outcome.
We will alter this outcome, Doctor.
On that, we most certainly agree, Hunter. It's not just the Sanctum Sanctorum that was lost yesterday, it was my protege, Wanda. She was, is, my charge, my responsibility, and I failed her. But I am determined not to let that happen with you, Hunter, which is why I am here to answer any questions you may have. Perhaps my wisdom may benefit you more than it has me thus far.
A creature on the roof. You have run into it before.
Unfortunately, yes. In the simplest of terms, Venom is an alien species living in symbiosis with a human known as Eddie Brock. He's something of a fixture in New York these days, but typically, his hijinks are confined to harassing Spider-Man.
How does Eddie feel about this arrangement?
He seems to relish the experience. And under Lilith's spell, they've clearly become more cohesive than ever before.
Let us talk later.
Visit whenever you like. It's not often I get to converse with a true legend.